of all, congrats on your new purchase. Nikon D5600. Okay. I'll tell you how to remove and put the lens. You know how to do that?
No.
Okay, not yet. Okay. To begin with, on and off. Okay. Video should always be like this. Okay. This is how you switch it on, switch it off, and this is the shutter button. You know, cut it. ಇನ್ನು ಹತ್ರ ತಗೋಬಾರ ನನ್ನ ಮುಖ ಬೇಡುವ ನನ್ನ ಮುಖ ಬೇಡ ಹತ್ರ ತಗೊಂಬ ಓಕೆ ಓಕೆ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಬಟನ್ ಹಿಯರ್
ಓಕೆ
ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಲಾಕ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಕಿಟ್ ಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಫಿಕ್ಸ್ಡ್ ಓಕೆ ಬಟ್ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ನಾಟ್ ಬಿ ಏಬಲ್ ಟು ಶೂಟ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್
ಓಕೆ
ಓಕೆ ಇವನ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಚೆಕ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಥ್ರೂ ದ ವ್ಯೂ ಫೈಂಡರ್ ಓಕೆ ಬಿಫೋರ್ ದಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಟಿಲ್ ಸ್ಕ್ರೀನ್ which is very 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 user friendly so you'll have to do like this and then put it back okay so again when you are keeping it or you can leave it like this only if you want
not
if you want you can just again do it like this and then put it back so it turns 360 degree again even if you're shooting something like this you can see yourself here as well okay and always keep your hands have this belt around your hand so that you don't put it down and if you're giving it to someone if somebody wants to use it you be proactive enough to put it around their neck okay so that they know the still they should also respect the device okay so always even if it is anybody who doesn't know how who's new to camera so always give it to them in that way so first let's tilt this let's put it back okay let's switch it on this is called live view button okay if you just see now you are seeing the details here right
it's
not a touch screen and for now you will be able to see only through this viewfinder this is viewfinder
okay
this is called live view
okay
So if you want to see the view here, then you just need to push it here. Okay, first I need to unlock this. Okay, this is live view.
Okay.
So you can shoot pics like this also. But usually the autofocus will be really, really, really poor. And it will be really slow if you are using it like this. Whereas if you are using the viewfinder, it is much faster. Okay. Again, to get rid of this live view, if you just need to push it again like this, you get all the settings. So, like I said, this is the lock. Okay. So when this lock is on, you will not be able to shoot anything. It will not shoot because you are not seeing the aperture number. That lens is not open, so that's why it is showing that error. So once if you have to press this, if you bring it till here, then the lock gets opened. Did you get the click sound? See that click sound. That means the lock is released. Now you cannot go beyond this way. You can zoom in from 18mm to 55mm. Okay. This is a DX lens, which is really nice. So now you will be able to click photos. Okay. And for this lens you do not have autofocus manual focus so even if it doesn't matter whether it is in autofocus or manual focus you can still roll this usually people will say if manual focus is on only then you can use this
okay
if autofocus is on then you should not be touching this at all okay so that's
this
good.
Is a what is the difference between this and this
this will give you the adjustment between focal length say for example let me so I'm going to use only the bigger
one
dial okay so see what happens if you start moving like this you are getting closer to the object But let's say after getting closer, maybe you want to zoom in or make it blur. So it's up to you. So this is the fine-tuning ring. So image gets focused properly, or you can make it blur also. Okay. So both, it happens in automatically also. See, now I'm not touching the ring, but still, if when I'm pushing the shutter button halfway, it automatically focuses. Okay. So that is the difference between this ring and this ring.
Okay, if at all, if I want to remove this,
what is this you want to remove? What do you want to remove?
Flash.
Okay. So usually, when you keep it in auto mode, the flash will, the camera will adjust itself to the lighting environment, and then it will decide whether it needs a flash. If you're in automatic mode, okay. So it will automatically pop up the flash, okay. But for manually, if you think it is in manual mode, but you know the situation is dark, you feel that I need little more light, okay. Then if you press this button, this is the flash button. If you press this, that will pop up. If you press this, it will pop up. So let me take one picture and show you how it looks. Did you get the flash?
Yeah.
Okay, and after you click the picture, after 3 seconds you will not be able to see anything. I mean, the picture will go off. Then you will have to use this button to play again. Look at yourself.
Cool.
Okay. So you can zoom in like this. Do you see this brightness?
Mm-hmm.
So this is day. We don't need brightness because this with this flash, this lighting is little harsh. Mm. It looks very artificial.
Mm.
Okay. If you press the button again, it will go off. I'll take one more picture without flash. Let's see how it is.
The same picture.
So this is much natural.
Natural, yeah.
It is not that sharp because maybe I shook it a little bit, or I did not wait for it to focus. But this is much natural.
Yes.
Or maybe the focus was on the mobile.
Mm-hmm.
Looks like you can touch. It's a touch screen, I guess.
Mm.
I don't know. I just found out. Video. So this is a touch screen as well. Nice. I didn't know this. Okay. Coming to this dial. Okay. This is M means manual.
Manual.
A.
Autofocus. Auto. Auto. Aperture.
That is called aperture.
Aperture.
A stands for aperture.
Aperture.
Priority. This is aperture mode. Let's call it as aperture mode. I'll tell you what happens when you keep this in aperture mode. This is S.
Shutter.
Shutter priority, shutter mode. What is this? P.
Pointer.
Program mode.
Program mode. Huh?
Okay. So each function has different different conditions to work. This is something called scene. Let's try how it is. This is auto, like I said. This is, if you're giving this camera to use to any of the kid or anybody who don't know camera, so always put it in auto mode so that this camera will automatically judge whether it needs light or not, and it will use flash also. So like that, they know the pictures will come out nicely. You don't have to break your head. But if you want it to be in auto, so in auto mode, if it requires flash, this will automatically pop up.
Mm-hmm.
You cannot stop that. But in auto, if you don't want flash, say for example in auto mode, let's see, I'm making this dark, okay, so that, see, I'm blocking the light, so camera will think it is dark situation, so, what is this, the flash is opened, okay, but in the same way, I want still dark, but in auto mode, I don't want the flash to come up, so if I keep it like this, then the flash will not come. So you are just fooling the camera.
Yeah, I got it.
But in auto mode, if it is dark, it will automatically pop it out. Okay. There are some more things called effects where you can, if you choose this, you can choose water seal out.
I can take this one.
So when it is seal out, when, what do you mean by seal out is when the light is in the foreground, background, okay, light source in the background, and you are standing here, and if you are in front of the light and if you take it like this, you will not be able to see anything, only the light. Light will be bright, you will be shown very dark. So that is called seal out mode, okay. Other one is high key, it is again high resolution, low key, seal out. So selective cover, color. So what this means is, now it is showing the entire picture is black and white, right?
Yeah.
Now I just want to select one color, so I touch it here.
It's live video.
See, now I'm going to pick what color I want. So now red is selected, right? So if I want to show only red color, as everything red and orange will be highlighted. Okay, in this one, in this side, there are different colors, but I want to make everything black and white. Basically, green, you can select only three colors, okay? Green, this is red, this is blue. So if I'm selecting this, if I adjust, then I'll be able to... Okay, no, I'm increasing only, picking up only green colors, okay? But if I under this, I'm picking up... Okay, we may have to recheck this. I'll let you know how the settings work.
Good.
But this is color, okay?
Sorry.
Miniature effect. So say for example, if you want to take something zoom, and if you want it to look like miniature, a small thing. So this is the right mode. So basically it's called macro. Other mode is, we have toy camera, okay, I'll show you with this. Now put your camera down. Take some time. So it's a different mode. The filter is different. One photo illustration, look at this. Pop. So what this will do is, this will pop out all the colors. Let me click.